come over to the TV and take a look at this little guy. We met him back in 1994 on his make-a-wish trip to a park in Maine to watch whales. He was battling a rare form of cancer at the time. Now you're going to fast forward almost 20 years, and he is out of college and ready to tackle the world.
Just amazing. Channel 4 Action News anchor Mike Clark joining us now. And Mike, you've followed his story all this time.
It's almost two decades.
Wow.
Andrew and Wendy, what a story this is. When I met Bryan Dwyer back in 1994, he told me that he wanted to be a crocodile scientist when he got older. He was a five-year-old ball of energy on a vacation of a lifetime during a difficult time in his life. But what Bryan and his family have lived through is a strong testament to the power of a wish.
Bryan Dwyer can't believe he is the little guy in this photo.
It's an honor, honestly, to be where I am. It's truly an honor.
20 years ago, Bryan's body battled against acute lymphocytic leukemia, a family's fight for his life.
We have a lot of faith, frankly, that this is going to work out, that we're going to overcome this and we're going to move on with our lives and be the family we are today.
To understand Bryan's gratitude, you have to go back 19 summers ago and the power of a wish.
Can I try one?
Don't pick the big ones.
I met Bryan at Acadia National Park, picking through his treasures found in Downeast Maine. Bryan's wish to go camping and watch whales, with an idea of what he'd do if he met a killer whale.
No, maybe I'd ride on his back.
Bryan developed a giant love for the deep sea when Mom and Dad read him these bedtime books, Big Mammals, Fueling Big Dreams. That week in Maine, Bryan did not see any whales, so he hitched a ride on my humpback.
But they have blowholes.
They do? I'll be a blowhole.
There was Bryan's first step into the Atlantic, a visit to an oceanarium. He and little brother Nicholas deputized as park rangers, the boys and their parents, Frank and Yvonne, building memories with no medical worries.
Just being here, there's no hospital, no doctor, no work. It's just very relaxing, and he couldn't have picked a better wish. I mean, this is back to nature, back to basics.
So they stayed positive and remained in prayer.
It put me in a really happy place. I obviously enjoyed it, and I go down memory lane when I look at it.
And Bryan beat his illness.
It propels you to think in a way that anything is possible.
The memories of that wish making him stronger.
You can do it. You can beat it. You can move on with your life after it.
This is how he moved on, after graduating college, boldly embarking on a year-long deep-sea adventure, once again chasing whales.
This is real right now, and this is something I've wanted to see my whole life.
Bryan and his girlfriend Katie traveled to New Zealand, Lake Taupo, and the Bay of Islands. Then, on a New Year's Eve kayaking trip, Bryan's wish came true.
I've never felt that vulnerable in my entire life, definitely.
A killer whale making a beeline for them.
You see the first spout, like it was a killer whale, and you just see like the black, like the spout black and then fin. You're just like, let's go. Like, just, it was adrenaline pumping. It was probably 15 feet. It was massive. I want to be like literally staring at this thing in the face.
Yes, his wish came true.
Wow. And then its fin just kind of coming at us and goes under the water, and I was in this, just in this little kayak, I could have stuck my hand down and just touched it, and you're like, wow.
19 years later.
Whatever you feel in your heart, make that your wish.
Still inspiring little boys and girls hoping for the power of a wish.
Can you believe that? What a great young man he is. I see the tears in your eyes right
now.
He still volunteers for Make-A-Wish. She's been doing it every year, volunteering, inspiring kids, letting them know that, hey, tomorrow is going to be better. He's looking for a job right now. He's a college graduate. If you have a job, hire this man.
Yeah.
He's awesome.
He's absolutely darling. And that you have followed him for 20 years.
Yeah. Yeah.
That's a connection.
Great family. You see that I'm wearing a mullet back in 1994?
Yeah.
Bryan said his father had a mullet as well. The entire report is online right now at WTAE.com. So
I love it.
Check it out.
Incredible
awesome
story.
Stuff.